Good morning, students. I'm Purnima and I would like to welcome you all in my class. Today I'm going to revise the same lesson, the ailing planet, the green movement's role. So students, in this I told you this lesson is written by Nani Palkhi Walia. She is a well-known lawyer, but children heard this article. It appeared in the newspaper, the Indian Express, and on 24th November 1994, and he talks about the ecological situation of the earth. So here he is talking about the ecological situation of the earth. The issue that raised regarding the declining health of the earth continue to have relevance even today. So this was the only movement which till now it is continued, it has been talk, it has been lot of people has taken interest in this movement. And now some important point of the lesson which I am going to discuss before beginning the before the explanation of the lesson. So children, the green movement, earth's living organism. In 1972, the world first nationwide green party was found in New Zealand. Since then, the movement has gripped the imagination of the entire human race, and it is being continued. Copernicus taught us that the earth and the other planets revolve around the sun. Similarly, the green movement has brought the idea that the earth is a living organism. So children, what was the main point of the green revolution? That earth, they are considering earth as a living organism, and we have moved towards a holistic and ecological view of the world. The earth vital sign to be a patient in declining health. Humans have realized their ethical obligation to protect and preserve the need of the planet. Well, the second most important point is the concept of sustainable development. The concept of sustainable development are popularized in 1987 by the World Commission on Environment and Development. It stressed the idea of development that meets the need of the present without compromise the ability of future generation to meet their needs. It means that we should pursue development for our present needs, but we should be careful about the needs of the future generation as well. Now children, in one of the zoo of Lusaka, there is a cage where the notice reads, "The world's most dangerous animal." Inside the cage, there is a mirror in which we see our reflection. With the continuous and sustained effort of a number of agencies in different countries, the human beings are realizing that they should not dominate the earth but respect her as a partner. Earth principle biological system. This is the third point which we are going to hear. Earth principle biological system. The Plant Commission was one of the first international commission which dealt with the question of ecology and environment. An Indian, Mr. L.K. Jha, was a member of this commission. The first brand report raised the question, are we to leave our successor a planet of advancing deserts, impoverished landscape and ailing environment? Mr. Lesser R. Brown, in his book, The Global Economic Prospect, points out Earth's four major biological systems that are fisheries, forest, grassland and croplands. These four are the foundation of the global economic system, and besides providing food, they provide nearly all the raw materials to industries. Human claims on this system are becoming unsustainable, and thus their productivity is being impaired. This has led to drastic results. Several species face extinction due to such destruction. Now, another point of this lesson, important point, is forest precede mankind, desert follow. The ancient patronymy of tropical forest is now ending at the rate of 40 to 50 million acres. The World Bank estimates that a 5-fold increase in the rate of forest planting is needed to cope up with the expected fuel wood demand in the year 2000. James Spath, the president of the World Resources Institute, revealed a very alarming statistic that we are losing the forest at an acre and a half a second. Article 48A of the Indian Constitution state that it is the duty of the state to make efforts to improve the environment and safeguard the forest and wildlife of the country. Unfortunately, laws are never respected nor enforced in India. Large areas officially designated as forest land are virtually treeless. The menace of overpopulation. The growth of world population is one of the strongest factors overshadowing the future. Every 4 days, the world population increases by 1 million. The population of India is more than the entire population of Africa and South America. Together, more children do not mean more workers. It merely means more people without work. The only solution to this is voluntary family planning. Era of responsibility. Slowly but steadily, people are understanding the concept that the entire world should be treated as an integrated whole rather than a collection of separate parts. For sustainable development of the world, everyone has to play his role, even the industries. Margaret Thatcher and Lazar Brown suggested that the earth is not our property. It passes on from one generation to another with the hope that each generation will take care of it so as to pass it on to the next with its resource intact. Mr. Brown has put this thought very beautifully. He said, "We have not inherited this earth from our forefathers. We have borrowed it from our children." So children, these were the all important points of the lesson. And now, children, I am going to do the explanation of the lesson. So children, we were there at page number 44. And the children, the third paragraph we were doing. Okay, now I'm going to do the explanation of the lesson. Brand Commission was one of the early international commission who dealt with questions of ecology and environment. They commissioned Mr. L.K. Jha as one of their commission members who was an Indian citizen. His first report raised a question that we are going to leave a burnt planet with aged deserts, poor landscapes and a poor environment for our future generation. Mr. Lazar R. Brown, in his thoughtful book, The Global Economic Prospect, points out that the Earth's principal biological system are four: fisheries, forests, grassland, and croplands, and they form the foundation of the global economic system. In addition, to supply our food, these four systems provide virtually all the raw material for our industries, except minerals and petroleum. Derived synthetics in large area of the world, human claims on these systems are reaching an unsustainable level, a point where their productivity is being impaired. When this happens, fisheries collapse, forests disappear, grasslands are converted into barren land, and cropland deteriorates. In a protein-conscious and protein-hungry world, overfishing is common every day. In poor countries, local forests are being decimated in order to procure firewood for cooking. In slum places, firewood has become so expensive that what goes under the pot now costs more than what goes inside it. Since the tropical forest, in the word of Dr. Myers, the powerhouse of evolution, several species of life face extinction as a result of its destruction. So children, these are some of the important points which I've told you, and now I will be writing the meaning of some of the words. Okay, and you have to write it. So synthetic here is artificial substance. These are some of the difficult meaning. Synthetic artificial substance, impaired, weakened or damaged, deteriorate, become progressively worse, decline, procure, obtain with care or effect. So these are some of the new words, and you have to learn the meaning of these words. So now so children, these are the things which fisheries, forest and greenland, cropland, they were giving raw material to the industries also, and they are giving children, they are helping to the human being also, but now they are becoming lesser and lesser, and due to this the ecological balance of the earth is being damaged, and the earth is becoming ailing. Ailing means it is becoming sick. It is losing its health. So it has been rightly said and well said that the forest precede mankind, desert follow. The word ancient patronymy of tropical forest is now eroding at the rate of 40 to 50 million acres a year, and the growing use of dung for burning deprived the soil of an important natural fertilizers. The World Bank estimated that the five-fold increase in the rate of forest planting is needed to cope with the expected fuel wood demand in the year 2000. James Speth, the president of the World Resource Institute, said the other day, "We were saying that we are losing the forest at an acre a second, but it is much closer to an acre and a half to a second." So children, precede means come before in order or position. Patrimony is property inherited from father or ancestor, and deprives here means prevent a person from using something. Forest and deserts come first in order in comparison to humans. The ancient inheritance of tropical forest is constantly wearing away at the rate of 40 to 50 million acres a year. Also, the burning of drug is preventing the soil to become natural fertilizer. At the same time, children, fuel wood is demanded by many people, and the need is increasing the rate of forest plantation by fivefold by the year 2020. We are losing the forest closer to an acre and a half to a second, according to James Spence, president of the World Resource Institute. Article 48A of the Constitution of India provides that the state shall endeavor to protect and improve the environment and to safeguard the forest and wildlife of the country. But what causes endless anguish is the fact that laws are never respected nor enforced in India. For instance, the Constitution said that the casteism, untouchability and bonded labor shall be abolished, but they flourish shamelessly even after 44 years of the operation of the Constitution. A recent report of our Parliament's Estimate Committee has highlighted the near catastrophic depletion of India forests over the last four decades. India, according to reliable data, is losing its forests at the rate of 3.7 million acres a year. So that is too much. A large area officially designated as forest land are already virtually treeless. The actual loss of forest is estimated to be about 88 times the rate indicated by the government statistic. So children, this is the situation in our country, and once again few word meanings are there which I am going to write, and then you can note it. So children, the meaning of endeavor is a very common word. Many times you will see this word is coming in the chapter. So endeavor, trying hard to achieve something. Anguish is pain or suffering. So children, these are some of the word meaning, okay, which you should remember it, we should learn it. According to the Article 48A of the Constitution of India, the state should try to protect and improve the environment and must protect the forest and wildlife of the country. But the painful fact is that laws are not followed in India. For example, casteism, untouchability and bonded labor, they are abolished but still are followed shamelessly over the last four decades. India is losing forest of a harmful rate of 3.7 million acres a year, as per the report of Parliament's Estate Committee. The large area of forest land is now treeless, and the actual loss is estimated to be 8 times the rate given by the government statistics. So you can see children how badly the forests are declining in our country. A 3-year study using satellite and serial photography conducted by the United Nations warns that the environment has deteriorated so badly that it is critical in many of the 88 countries investigated. There can be no doubt that the growth of world population is one of the strongest factor distorting the future of human society. It took mankind more than a million years to reach the first billion. That was the world population around the year 1800. By the year 1900, a second billion was added, and the 20th century has added another 3.7 billion. The present world population is estimated at 0.5.7 billion. Every 4 days, the world population increased by 1 million. Now, children, distorting means disform or disfigure. According to the 3-year study conducted by the United Nations Children using satellites and aerial photography, our environment has got so bad that in 88 countries, it has reached the critical stage. Growth of world population at such a fast rate is one of the strongest reasons behind the deterioration of the future of mankind. When it took more than a million years to reach the first billion population, in the next 100 years, the population number increased by the next billion number. In the 20th century, the population reached 3.7 billion and the present number is 5.7 billion. Presently, the case is of the population increasing by 1 billion every 4 days. Now, children, fertility falls as incomes rise. Education spread and health improves. Thus, development is the best contraceptive. But development itself may not be possible if the present increase in numbers continue. The rich get richer and the poor beget children, which condemns them to remain poor. More children does not mean more workers, merely more people without work. It is not suggested that human being be treated like cattle and compulsory sterilized, but there is no alternative to voluntary family planning without introducing an element of coercion. The choice is really between control of population and perpetuation of poverty. Now, beget means give life to. Condemns, find guilty of something. Sterilized, make free from bacteria or other microorganism. Voluntary, done or given of one's free will. Coercion is force. Perpetuation is keep going. Now, development is the best possible solution for overpopulation. It can help in reduction in fertility and rise in income. To spread more education and improvement in health. But if the number of population will keep increasing, it may not help in attaining any kind of development. As the rich get richer, the poor birth children who are bound to remain poorer. More population will lead to more unemployment. Human should not be treated like cattle who are sterilized by force, but to control population, some element of force has to be put on for family planning. Now humans have to choose between population control and keeping up with poverty. So children, the population of India is estimated to be 920 million today, more than the entire population of Africa and South America put together. No one is familiar with the condition in India would doubt that the hope of the people would die in their hungry hutments unless population control is given topmost priority. For the first time in human history, we see a transcending concern, the survival not just of the people but of the planet. We have begun to take a holistic view of the very basis of our existence. The environmental population does not necessarily signal our demise. It is our passport for the future. The emerging new world vision has ushered in the era of responsibility. It is a holistic view on ecological view, seeing the world as an integral whole rather than a dissociated collection of parts. Well, children, there are many difficult words are here which I am going to explain you. Hut means collection of hut. What is the meaning of hut means? Collection of hut. Transcending concern means a concern that existed for a very long time. And it is passed from one generation to another. Demise means death. Ushered means guide someone somewhere. That is the meaning of ushered. So children, once again, I am going to tell you the population of India is 920 million. That is more than the population of Africa and South America together. If the population is not controlled, most of the people would die in their hearts with just a hope. And with time, people are now concerned about the survival of the planet. We have now started to see our existence with a comprehensive view. Solving environmental problems are a passport to the future and should not be seen as a remark of our death. We should see the world as a whole and not as a different part. Industries has a most crucial role to play in this new era of responsibility. What a transformation would be effected if more businessmen shared the view of the chairman of DuPont, Mr. Edgar S. Woodland, who 5 years ago declared himself to be the company's chief environmental officer. He said, "Our continued existence as a leading manufacturer requires that we excel in environmental performance." Of all the statements made by Margaret Thatcher during the years of her prime ministership, none has passed so decisively into the current coin of English usage as her fallacious word. No generation has a freehold on this earth. All we have a life tenancy with a full repairing lease. In the words of Mr. Lazar Brown, we have not inherited the earth from our forefather, we have borrowed it from our children. So children, some of the difficult word meaning which I am going to write it on the board here. So these are some of the new words, children, which you have to note it down. Decisively, clear, and definitive. Then fallacious is well chosen. Then so children, you can see now we have we are going to end the lesson, and last part of the lesson is there. So children, according to the words of Mr. Brown, we are, what he told in the words of Mr. Lesser Brown, he told that we have not inherited this earth from our forefather, we have borrowed it from our children. Okay, that means borrowed means we are taking as a debt. The right of use of land for some time is and we are taking it, we are not borrowing it from our forefather, but we have borrowed it from our children. So with this, the lesson completed, and with this I conclude my video here. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.